is it about trial and error learning that is particularly good for older adults' brain or their memory? Well, when we're making errors, even though that sounds like those are bad things, we're actually creating associations to the information that we're supposed to remember. So for instance, if you're studying a farm animal and you guess pig and horse and the answer is cow, even though it seems like those errors should really interfere with your memory, you're actually creating all of this rich information that is connected to the information that you're supposed to learn. So when somebody asks you later on about what is that farm animal that I tried to get you to learn before, not only do you remember the information that you were supposed to learn, but you also remember all of these rich associations that you formed at the time. And it's this richness or this distinctiveness of that learning process that can benefit older adults.